down to the sea. You become such a habit with me. America, America.
If anyone has earned the right to be known as a rebel with a cause, it's Waylon Jennings. Now, he's soared to some pretty incredible heights as one of America's leading country and western singers and songwriters. But along that journey, he plunged to some despairing lows.
On the day the music died, Waylon gave up his seat aboard rock and roll's tragic air crash that killed Buddy Holly. He was just a backup musician in Buddy's group, The Crickets, and turned over his ticket to the Big Bopper.
He claims that his career was marred by a 20-year drug dependency that left him absolutely penniless and with three broken marriages. But he's always fought like a tiger for his musical stardom.
Waylon says that he gives all the credit for his turnabout to wife number four, country singer Jessie Coulter. During the bad times, she made the difference between her man going down and going out.
She coped with it and in the end helped me get off of drugs. You know, she never gave up faith in me, or never gave up hope that I would get off of them someday. She always believed that I'd get off of them, and I did finally.
It seems like the last few years have just been a rebirth and reawakening of everything, you know, for us. And I just kind of feel like we're a couple of kids, and the world's our playground in a way, you know.
He's won more awards, gold and platinum albums, than he can remember, and all for singing his songs straight from the heart.
But you don't understand, they keep a show in my hands and not my face on TV.
Even with record sales of over 15 million, Waylon's proudest possession is a Grammy for this hit song.
I was a dam builder across the river deep and wide.
Home is Nashville, near Kris Kristofferson and Johnny Cash, his best buddies. Waylon lives in a thoroughly modern, secluded estate with Jesse and their young son, Shooter, for whom the tour bus is named. The Jennings home is elegant, yet almost understated by rhinestone and glitz standards. Waylon says comfort comes first, and his prized gold Cadillac is one of his rare gestures to conspicuous consumption.
Waylon's a very casual person. We're very casual in our lifestyle, and Waylon loves his den, and I love being with him as much as I can in the house, so we kind of center to the den a lot. The kitchen is possibly the most favorite place in the house, because we're definitely food-oriented around here. And this room is just a lovely room to come into when I just want to feel, I don't know, real private. I come in here and sit, or you watch the snow fall, and the light hits it perfectly out here. I think more than anything, my house is comfortable. I have lovely things, but I'm not one of these people who cares to remind anybody to take care of it.
I grew up a dreaming of being a cowboy, loving the cowboy.
His is a lifetime fascination with the Old West.
I think everybody, you know, secretly wants to be a cowboy, or wanted to be a cowboy sometime in their life. That's the true American hero. You know, I went down to Texas and did a documentary about cowboys. And I spent 2 weeks on a roundup. And I found out what I wasn't. I'm not a cowboy. I'm a cowboy singer.
So, where'd he get those cowboy ways, Jesse?
He's from Texas. And I don't know, Texans just kind of feel like the way they say it is it. Anybody else is off a little, you know. So, in fact, I wrote a song once called, "Just Because I'm Not from Texas Doesn't Mean I'm from Overseas," because they basically treat you like you're a foreigner.
But Jesse's no stranger to the gentle outlaw who survived his last bad roundup.
You got to be able to laugh at yourself and laugh at each other, you know. And I'm pretty funny. Jesse's had a lot of good laughs.
You'd better believe Waylon gets a few chuckles when Jesse throws a party and miraculously turns their home into an art gallery featuring his favorite cowboy art, and for a fashion show with furs and dresses by her favorite designer. The guest list included the Grand Ole Opry's finest friends, Roseanne Cash, Chet Atkins, Crystal Gayle, and Emmylou Harris.
I just moved to Nashville a couple of years ago, and so now I see them more than... No, and we sort of live down on the same road. Everybody in Nashville is close to everybody else.
And everyone in Nashville feels a special bond with their friend, the country superstar who turned his life around and in doing so discovered peace of mind. Waylon Jennings, still an outlaw, but reformed.